I'm Charles Lore, and I'm coming to you in infrared because it's the same way the Vive sees the world around it. By sees, it's a little bit different than you might be thinking. It's not really a camera-based tracking system, and that's why it's so cool. Ever since I was able to finally play it, I mean, I've tried other tracking systems, but this just takes the cake. Unlike so many other solutions where they'll try to use cameras and back out barrel distortion and then use the whole images and do image processing and try to figure out constellations of points and what poses could be and all of this complicated stuff, the HTC Vive uses something far more simplistic and way cooler. It uses lighthouses. A single lighthouse just sends out a flash of light and then sweeps the room one way with light and sweeps it the other way. And by doing that, it can figure out exactly where all of the objects are. And that's just so cool. The second part about why this is so cool is because the chief ferologist at Valve, and all of the ferologists, I suppose, there, were able to make this system bulletproof. Just amazing. There's only one problem, though. It's not open source. There was no way for me to really dig in, to learn from it, to really understand how this works, or, I don't know, I like taking things apart and seeing if I can make some little piece better. And it's just not possible. So I set forth and I said, I wanna do this. I wanna go write my own. And I had no idea just how much was involved. I was foolish. I was like, okay, so what have people figured out? They've already reverse engineered how the data comes in through this thing. But they didn't reverse engineer how the data comes through this thing. Just like the Vive, the headset, it has all of the little sensors dotted all over, and these are the things that receive the light, but it's wireless, and it's a really restricted wireless link. And so I said, you know, whatever, we'll just hack it, we'll do it live. I'll just go throw up a live stream, and we'll figure it out. We'll just figure out how this thing works. And then the crazy thing was, we did. And I say we, because it wasn't me sitting here and figuring this thing out. It was me sitting here and just, like, reading data off the sensors and getting it to people on the internet, and they were analyzing and figuring out how it all fit together. And we did it. In two live streams, we reverse engineered this thing. And that was just the tip of the iceberg. Now, I say we did. Some of the folks at Valve, they were really nice and helped us along a little bit, and that's just been great. Which, in its own sense, is really cool. But the neat thing was that this was a community project to hack just this little piece. So we didn't stop there. I said, heck, we hacked this. How much harder could it be to do full tracking? You know, to get this done in like three live streams. We were wrong. After 9.5 live streams, we didn't. We got a long ways, but what we did mostly was uncover the plentitude of cleverness that was imparted on the entire system from the folks at Valve. And it's just amazing to see how many pieces have to work together and why this system shouldn't work, but it does. So, in addition to finding all of these cool things, we also now have libsurvive, a system that has many pluggable components, parts where you can take these and plug them in as hardware into systems that will figure out the angles and all the calibration, and then disambiguators, actually I guess use the disambiguator to figure out the times, to figure out the angles, and then from all of the angles between the lighthouse and this thing, it can then take that and then use posers and figure out exactly where the objects can be relative to the lighthouses, and all of the calibration for the IMU is in, and it's not done yet. You can't just go slap this on your face and play a game with libsurvive yet. That's because we're not there. Though it's been amazing to end this journey so far, having people like ArsenoDev, who were, as far as I can tell, he's a rocket scientist who's just taking it on himself to go take a lighthouse and build one himself. To Octavio, who saw this going and he just had to be a part of it, and he didn't even know C, but he did know algorithms pretty well, so he wrote his own poser. And that poser was implemented by MW Turvey, who wants to use this system in his daughter's wheelchair to help with indoor navigation. And people like Luke58, who just want to use this on a much smaller scale. And because libsurvive is so stripped down, I'm pretty sure I'm going to be able to run it on an ESP32. people like Geekmaster Rob, who also hopped in and just joined in to help figure out, well, what systems could we run it on? How can we run it on the most minimal hardware? And all of these people, all of them work together, but we're still not there. We've got a long way, but we're not there. So what's next? Well, that might be where you come in. Hop in the Discord, say hi, check out it on GitHub, see if you can get it to build, see if you can get your Vive to run with libsurvive, and if you can't, file a bug report, tell us why. We'll try fixing it. And all of these pieces, you can be a part of it. Heck, do you know anything about Kalman filters? Because I don't. I'm pretty sure we need one. I don't know how it works. All of these pieces are going to fit together, and we're going to do it. But you might be the force that helps us go all the way.